Hey everyone, it's Ken here, bringing you all the latest Tesla news you don't want to miss. First up, Tesla's full self-driving FSD is on the brink of receiving highway approval in Europe. If this goes through, how far can Tesla push its FSD deployment? Next, there's some pressure mounting on Panasonic as Tesla is urging them to ramp up battery production in the US. But what's the real motive behind Tesla's push for increased domestic production? Then, we've got Elon Musk's The Boring Company eyeing a major contract with Amtrak. Could the tunnel business become Tesla's next big influence on the stock price? Also, a wave of corporate exits from Delaware, dubbed the Dexit, is underway, with Tesla leading the charge. But what risks are lurking behind this trend? And finally, we'll cover Tesla's resumed importation of Chinese-made components for the Semi and Cybertruck, plus the company's new data collection operator job for Optimus. This is a jam-packed episode for Tesla owners, investors, and fans alike. So stick around to the end. You won't want to miss this. All right, let's dive into the first big story. Tesla's full self-driving is set to hit a new milestone in Europe. The United Nations Economic Commission for Europe, UNEC, has just approved a new regulation that could greenlight partial FSD operations on highways starting September 26th. Under the new rule, what's called system-initiated maneuvers, SIM, will be permitted on highways. This means Tesla's FSD will be allowed to handle lane changes, acceleration, and deceleration automatically. But there's a key limitation to keep in mind. Urban driving is still restricted. For example, the system won't yet cover complex urban scenarios like interpreting traffic signals or managing intersections. So, even if FSD performs flawlessly on highways, full self-driving in city settings is still a ways off. And in Europe, driver attention remains a big deal. This regulation will still require drivers to keep their hands on the wheel, what's known as a steering nag. So while we're not talking about full hands-free driving just yet, this is still a massive step forward for autonomous tech. Stay tuned because there's a lot more to come. Now, let's shift gears to Panasonic. Tesla is reportedly turning up the heat on them to accelerate US battery production. The reason? The Inflation Reduction Act, IRA. Under the IRA, EV manufacturers can score some serious tax incentives, but only if they use batteries made in the US. Tesla's goal is clear: reduce dependency on Chinese-made batteries and build a more secure supply chain domestically. Now, let's shift gears to The Boring Company, led by Elon Musk. The latest buzz? They're eyeing a massive tunnel project with Amtrak. The project in question is the Frederick Douglass Tunnel, a plan to replace a century-old rail tunnel between Baltimore and Washington, D.C. The current tunnel is over 150 years old and structurally deteriorating. Initially estimated at $6 billion, the project's budget has now ballooned to $8.5 billion. Enter The Boring Company. Musk claims his tunneling tech can drastically cut costs compared to traditional methods. The Boring Company already has some experience under its belt, including the Las Vegas Convention Center loop. For the Amtrak project, they're aiming to leverage that experience to reduce costs and shorten timelines. But there are risks involved. The Amtrak tunnel project is government-led, and Musk's ties to Trump, having served as an advisor, could raise conflict of interest concerns. Also, The Boring Company's tech is still considered relatively unproven. Reports indicate that the Las Vegas loop has faced some operational hiccups, including occasional traffic congestion. The question now is whether their technology can handle a project of this scale. Next up, let's talk about Dexit, the mass corporate exodus from Delaware. Tesla was one of the first to move its incorporation to Texas, and now more companies are following suit. Why did Tesla leave Delaware? It all started with a 2024 court ruling. Delaware's court invalidated Elon Musk's $56 billion pay package, calling it excessive. Musk's response? He took to X, formerly Twitter, and said, "Don't incorporate in Delaware." That statement triggered a wave of exits from the state. For instance, Dropbox and the Trade Desk have moved to Nevada. Trump Media and Technology Group relocated to Florida. And more California-based companies are making the switch. So, why is Delaware suddenly out of favor? First, it's become a legal hotbed for shareholder lawsuits, as evidenced by Musk's case. Second, states like Nevada and Texas are offering more business-friendly legal protections and tax incentives. Nevada, for instance, has robust legal shields for corporate insiders. Texas, on the other hand, is a tax haven for businesses. For Delaware, this exodus is a financial blow. Nearly one-third of its budget comes from incorporation fees and related taxes. If the corporate migration continues, it could spell trouble for the state's finances. Now, how does this Dexit trend impact Tesla's stock? Reducing legal risks could be a short-term relief for Musk, but regulatory uncertainty in new states like Nevada and Texas could pose new challenges. Now, let's move on to Tesla's resumed imports of Chinese-made components for the Semi and Cybercab. Production plans for both are finally gaining traction. The catalyst for the resumed imports? A recent US-China trade deal that temporarily eases tariffs. With these cost reductions, Tesla can now bring in essential parts for the Semi and Cybercab, restarting production. However, this move comes with risks. US-China relations remain tense, and the tariff reductions are temporary. If tariffs are reinstated, Tesla could face soaring costs, impacting the pricing and profitability of the Semi and Cybercab. Stay tuned for more updates on this evolving situation. And finally, let's talk about Tesla's new job listing for data collection operators for the Optimus humanoid robot project. So, what's the job all about? Basically, these operators will wear motion capture suits and VR headsets to record human movements. These data points will then be used to train Optimus to mimic human actions accurately. There are some physical requirements too. Applicants need to be between 5 feet 6 inches and 6 feet tall and must be able to carry up to 30 pounds while walking for over 7 hours a day. Yep, it's a physically demanding role. And the pay? It's impressive. Hourly wages range from $25.25 to $48. That's up to $150,000 a year for top earners. This high pay scale shows just how seriously Tesla is taking the Optimus project. Why now? The reason for this hiring spree is clear. Tesla wants to accelerate Optimus's development. According to Morgan Stanley, the humanoid robot market could reach $5 trillion by 2050, and Tesla is eager to get a head start by refining Optimus's capabilities in industrial and warehouse applications. Tesla recently released footage of Optimus sorting colored blocks, showcasing the robot's improving dexterity. This data collection effort aims to fine-tune those skills even further. So, what do you think of today's Tesla updates? From FSD in Europe to battery production pressure, tunnel deals, corporate exodus, and Optimus, Tesla continues to shake things up. Before we wrap up, let's check Tesla's stock price. It's up again, hitting $346, just shy of the $350 mark. All right, that's a wrap for today's video. If you found this breakdown helpful, don't forget to hit the like button. And if you're not subscribed yet, make sure to do so. I post daily updates on everything Tesla. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Keep enjoying the Tesla life.